Good morning, everyone, and thank you for joining us for St. Mark Lutheran Preschool's Christmas program entitled Christmas Hide and Seek. Sheila reminded me that this is our first annual virtual program and hopefully our last virtual program. We'll hopefully be able to do this again in person next year. Sit back and enjoy. We really hope that you enjoy our production of Christmas Hide and Seek.
All right, Luke. I need you guys to go out into the hall. Luke and Haley, be listening for the words.
Ready or not, here we come. Look, Mary and Joseph had traveled to Bethlehem, and now they needed to find a place to sleep for the night. Lots of other people had traveled to Bethlehem too. Many of the rooms were already taken. Mary and Joseph walked by many places that didn't have a room for them. Then finally, they came to a sign that said, "Barn here." Mary and Joseph were very excited to have found a place to sleep. Sleeping in a barn was much better than sleeping outside. They had never slept in a barn before, so this was going to be an adventure. Before Mary and Joseph went into the barn, they knocked on the door. Ready or not, here we come. When they opened the door, Mary and Joseph looked inside and saw some animals hiding in the barn. Joseph pointed to a cow and a donkey hiding behind some hay bales. Mary pointed to some sheep, also hiding. The animals in the barn had all done a good job of hiding, but Mary and Joseph had also done a good job of finding them. They found all of the animals in the barn, and now it was time for Mary's baby to be born. Mary gave birth to a baby boy, and she named him Jesus. Jesus was a special baby, because Jesus was born as the Savior of the world. This was the best day the animals had ever had. They had fun playing hide and seek, and they also thought it was fun to have baby Jesus in the barn. As Mary lay, or Jesus laid in Mary's arms, they all began to celebrate and sing.
Thank you.
While Jesus slept in the barn in Bethlehem, there were some shepherds outside of town who were playing hide and seek with their sheep in a field. Ready or not, here we come. The sheep were good at hiding, but the shepherds were also good at finding them. In the middle of their game, the shepherds got a visit from the angels. The angels were surrounded by a bright light, and the shepherds were scared of the angels. They got so scared they went and hid in the hay. One of the angels spoke and said, "Do not be afraid. I am here with good news. My good news will make all the people happy. Today, your Savior is born in Bethlehem. You will find a baby wrapped in cloth and lying in a manger." Then the angels were praising God and saying, "Glory to God in the highest, and may there be peace and goodwill toward all on earth."
Yeah! open yet.
Wise men, pick up your gifts.
I need to go to the bathroom.
There were three wise men who had heard about a baby that was born. This baby was the savior of the world and would be a king among kings. They decided to travel long and far to see this king and wanted to bring him gifts of gold, frankincense, and myrrh. But they needed help from God to find Jesus. God promised to send a star that would lead them to where the Savior was. The wise men followed that star, and when they found the Savior, the wise men worshiped Jesus and gave him the gifts that they had traveled so far to give. The birth of the Savior Jesus is good news for all of us. It reminds us that God is always with us. When we are traveling like Mary and Joseph, when we are outside playing like the shepherds, when we are singing like the angels, and when we are trying to find our way like the wise men. Let's not hide the good news of Christmas. Let's find ways to tell others the good news of Jesus. Emmanuel, the promise that God is always with us.
Christmas gets stuck.
Frank, all I can do is run back to your spot.
Stuck. Not done yet.